I would like first to thank TED for having me here. I would like to quickly take you through the journey of my life, which I call the University of Hard Rocks of Life. It was only after my college that my real education began. I started my career selling shoes from a little shop that my father had started. I observed that there was a very little room to grow, and I was offered a full-time job in a nationalized bank. I declined the offer as I wanted to do something of my own where I can enjoy what I do. About 33 years ago, I started with two looms in my own house in a small town, Churu, in Rajasthan, as a contract manufacturer producing rugs for the larger exporters in India. I borrowed $200 from my father to buy the looms and an old cycle to travel to weaver houses day-to-day work. The beginning was humble yet filled with challenges. One of the first challenges I faced from my own family, in those days, rug weavers belonged to the untouchable class and were not given the social standards as others. Given the strong class system in India, interaction was not only discouraged, but was looked down upon. I faced a lot of resistance from my own family members and neighbors, but I couldn't understand how could they be different human beings. I fell in so much in love with weaving and weavers that I used to take my lunch and eat with weavers and their families beside the looms which they made their carpets. I used to spend entire day working with them, learn the basics of weaving. I discovered and realized that some of the most beautiful rugs in the world were made by those who don't have the most basic rights. The only encouragement I had was from my wife, who not only supported me but also sometimes provided the weavers with tea and food. Within 2 years, after establishing 10 looms in and around my village in Rajasthan, and therefore I further expanded as a contractor for next 8 years. After that, I moved to Jaipur to start my own export with my brother. In 1990, I moved to Gujarat, where I stayed for 8 years. In this period, I had the opportunity to train and develop a network of about 15,000 tribal men and women in the art of carpet weaving. Initially, I faced challenges working with the tribal who were not only welcoming the outsider, but I knew that love, empathy, and respect can make the relationship much easier. Just in a matter of 3-4 years, they started me to respect as their mentor. My interest to living in the villages and being close to the nature made it easier for me to connect with the tribal people and grow this business. During that time, I was blessed with 3 daughters and 2 sons. In my society at that time, even now, girls get less priority than the boys. My British friend Aile Cooper suggests that girls are often more efficient and more receptive. So my wife and I treated all my children equally, sent the girls to study in America, even though our family tradition strongly disapproved of sending a girl abroad alone. I encourage all my children to take a deep interest in the American lifestyle, especially that of the housewife who is the end consumer of our product, so that when they finish their studies, they would have a better understanding of the customer needs. I told them that I considered myself as a weaver, and thus they were daughters of a weaver, that weaving had become the biggest enjoyment of my life, and they must never forget this. One thing I learned was to appreciate the wisdom that the people at the grassroots level generally have. Women manage home, food, children, budget, and still take time to weave the carpets. They are probably some of the best managers in the world. In 1999, I separated from my brother and started Jaipur Rag. I also established a company in USA to move closer to the customer. Initially, I had a little knowledge of business and finance, as I spent most of my time with the weavers in the villages. As a result, I had to face a lot of problem. It was one of the most challenging moments of my life, where I had to learn the things which I did not learn in the last 20 years of my life. Up to now, I have relied upon the entrepreneurial skills and leadership qualities of the uneducated people, and they have gained a deep understanding of our business. But to support the rapid growth of the business, I had to hire fresh and experienced educated professionals. But they put me upside down. That was the right time for me to learn how to deal with professionals. I learned that knowledge is power, but too much knowledge and knowledge gained without practice develops ego. Practitioners sometimes get the skills without having the knowledge. To break the ego of the professionals, I started a learning initiative which we named the Higher School of Unlearning. We made the professional work with our older uneducated managers in different departments to develop a deep understanding about our business processes. I also took the challenge to teach them the basic fundamentals to manage a business and people like ours, which they never learned in their school and colleges. We worked in the meantime, we developed a management philosophy, finding yourself through losing yourself. The more I lose myself, the more I find myself. I observed that it was me who was restricting the growth of the organization, as I was everywhere in each decision. So I had to remove myself, my perception from every decision and use the natural talent and wisdom and the capability of the individual to see the things as they are, not as I want to be. I was like an ice cube. So losing myself was like melting the ice to become the water, as it can flexible and take any shape to become simple enough to let natural growth happen. In early 2008, Professor C.K. Pahlad called me and asked me if I knew him, who he was. I replied, "Who does not know you?" But I was extremely surprised why he has called me. He said that he wanted to do a case study on my business model. And then I said that what we do is very, very simple. What if you write it? I think no one will read it. Even my neighbors does not know me. But he explained me that our global supply chain was very unique by connecting the world's poorest with the richest. After talking to him, I realized that we have done a few things right to reach where we are. First is our vertical integration and nurturing the capability of the people at the grassroots. There are 60 processes in carpet making, from buying of raw wool to the final delivery. All these processes are highly influenced by us. That gives us a competitive advantage by having the quality control at each level, by developing the skills of uneducated people working at the different various levels. Hundreds of our weavers have risen to become either managers in our business, such as branch managers, and became entrepreneurs. Secondly, passing on more benefits to the weavers. While hand-knotted carpet fetch good value in the market, weavers who are the real creators receive only a fraction of this because of the middlemen involved in making and selling the carpets. I noticed this early on and started going directly to the weavers, eliminating the middlemen. We could therefore pass on more benefit to the weavers and sometimes at 10% more than what earned through a middleman. That was a very challenging process as I was taking somebody's business. So I was constantly threatened by many contractors. One day, a politically powerful contractor came to my office with a gun and asked me, leave the Gujarat, but I knew that it was a frustration of his failure. I believe that innovation will be a key for Jaipur Raksh to grow further. One of the new initiatives is to include our viewers in the product development and design process to unleash the creativity of the talented artisans we work with. My future vision for Jaipur Raksh is to allow the artisans to the greater share of the wealth they produce. Also, I want Jaipur Raksh to be a platform of connecting the end consumer with the artisans so that they both can emotionally connect with each other. I consider myself privileged to have worked with some of the most talented artisans in the country. Thank you.